I'm at the entrance to a large, beautiful off-leash dog park with my Lycan Shepherd Toki. Absolutely beautiful day. We got several inches of snow last night. It's gonna be slow going through the deep snow. Ready, buddy? Come along. Again, you can see how deep the snow is. It's beautiful. Like a fairy tale. Man, I'm already tired walking through this deep snow. Once we get down into the valley, it's going to be really slow. Man, it's deep here. Slow going today. This snow is deep. Just had that big clump of snow fall on me from the tree above. I don't know if you guys heard that. Thank you. All right, come on. It's beautiful, huh? I love it when it's like this. It's like living in a giant snow globe. Isn't it stunning? He decided to come this way after all. Snow on the lens, nope. Cow, am I getting tired? Walking through the snow is a workout. listening for their dog. Stop for a second. Yeah, that's a workout. Someone looking for their dog, Toke? Over there. See that guy running through the woods? Husky's taking off on him. How you doing? I saw him run that way. There he is. Who's that? Handsome dog.
Thank you, Ed. Nice to work.
Well, you get a workout walking in this stuff today. Friends, Toke? Let's see, that's a large size husky, and Toki's very large compared to it. He's a big dog. Come on, Toke. Oh boy. Legs are gonna be sore tomorrow. Friend coming back over to say hi, buddy. You digging in the stinky mud? Fortunately, running through all the snow will clean all that up. You can see even in the coldest of temperatures, they willingly go in the water. The thick double coat really keeps them warm. Oh, this is deep. That's up to my knees there. Just stunningly beautiful. I love it. Husky over there. Good boy. Just a little snow there to try to get him to pose for me. You're pretty. Good boy, buddy. Thank you. Which the snow fell from the tree.
It almost got you, didn't it?
Man, I was tired. Yeah, this deep snow ain't no joke. So good boy. Man, this is a workout. Did you hear my knee pop there, Toke? That's how you look back when it happened. I had lateral meniscus surgery on my right knee years ago, and I need it on my left one now. I can tell it pops out sometimes. One. That ain't getting fixed anytime soon, though. Despite having health insurance, man, it sucks now compared to what it used to be. All the co-pays and stuff like that, it never used to be like that when I was younger. What's the point of having it? Come on. Boy. But well, there's a branch that fell since yesterday. Whole tree that wasn't down when I came by here yesterday. Holy cow, man. You have a pound or two of snow on each boot. Man, I gotta stop and rest again. What's up, good boy? Jeez. This way. Good boy. And again, Toki's turned into a great trail dog, just like Ookla. He's got an awesome temperament. I really love his structure. He's the total package, in my opinion, for what I'm trying to create with the Lycan Shepherd Project. Not bad for a third generation cross in the process. It's only gonna get better from here. Holy cow, man. I am exhausted. Good boy. As my drill sergeant used to say, you gotta live hard to be hard. Fortunately, the nature of my injury from being hit by a truck, I'm most comfortable when I'm moving around. So that's why I'm out hiking like this every day with the dogs in all weather. It's the time when I experience the least amount of pain from my injury. got hit by a truck years ago on the job. Man, it feels so wonderful to be out in the air like this. Feel it in your lungs, snow on the skin, your blood pumping, breathing heavy. I love this, I truly do. And I appreciate it all the more because, again, there was a time after my injury when, you know, I couldn't walk. I used a cane for several years. I didn't think I'd ever be able to get out and do this. And so it just makes it taste all the sweeter when I can. And I'm gonna enjoy every bit of it because, as I learned before, you never know when these things can be taken away from you. You know, live in the moment and enjoy them. Enjoy them like it might be your last time, because again, you never know. It would have been a good day for a small pair of snowshoes. I used to have some years ago. Again, sorry about the frequent rest, man. This is really taxing. I need the breather. Whenever I'm feeling like this, I always hear my airborne drill sergeant saying, suck it up, airborne, drive on. Embrace the suck, they used to say. You know, it's funny, you know, here it is, over 35 years later, and I still see my drill sergeant's face and hear their voices in my head regularly. I even still remember their names. One was Drill Sergeant Hardman. Yeah, that was his name, Hardman. He was this big buff black guy. He was just ripped, and man, he used to smoke us in PT. He was one of those guys that was always up there in front leading by example. And then the other one was Drill Sergeant Hardwick, and he was an old Vietnam vet, hard as nails, and built like a piece of gristle. By that I mean he looked like a little more beefed up Iggy Pop with a high and tight. Absolutely beautiful. suck it up and drive on, Airborne. Holy cow, this is getting deep again. There's no trees overhead to catch it and hold it in their branches. And so in these open areas, it gets even deeper and harder to walk in. And it's 32 degrees right now, right at freezing point Fahrenheit. So the snow is very sticky. Good snowball weather. You know, that's one thing when it's super cold, you know, you get around zero or so and it's snowing, the snow is real wispy and powdery. It's a lot easier to walk your way through than this dense, heavy, wet snow here. Deep, eh, Toki? How far are we into this? Wow, 43 minutes. Battery's getting ready to die. If it just cuts out, that's why. If you made it this far, thanks for coming along and watching. I hope you enjoyed it. This is my absolute favorite weather to hike in. I love to hike in the rain too. I guess you could say I'm a fan of precipitation. Like, subscribe, and share. Hit that notification bell down below. You'll get email notifications when our new videos come out. Again, YouTube's been screwing with the channel a lot lately. People are constantly getting unsubscribed and reporting that to me. They're not getting my videos and their notifications. Those of you who make it, I'm back. Battery died, I had to replace it. As I was saying, people are constantly getting unsubscribed. They're telling me in the comments they aren't getting notifications for my videos. And you know, so if you're making it to my videos daily still with all that, I appreciate it. Thanks for watching. Check out our merch store if you want to help support the channel. There's also that thanks button at the bottom there. Best wishes from all of us. We're going to keep walking, but I wanted to get that in there. Come on. inches of snow fell on Toki's back. Pause it here. I have to climb up a hill, and in the steep snow I'm gonna need both hands to do it, so we'll be back shortly. Woo! Holy cow, that was a rough climb. I tell you what, if I had a bad heart, I'd have dropped dead on this hike, man. It's about an hour or so of heavy cardio. Again, the snow conditions are just right. You know, you got 10, 12 inches of fresh, wet, heavy snow. Temperature is at 32 degrees, keeping the snow wet and heavy. Whew. Man. Amy's got her doctor's appointment later today. We find out, hopefully, what's wrong with her shoulder. I hope they don't do the thing where they just look at it and then they make an appointment for you to go see a specialist. That always sucks. Up again. That hill killed me. Again, this has been up there in top five most taxing hikes I've done physically filmed on the channel. This has really been a workout. All these beautiful oak trees through here. They're beautiful. Well, getting close to my Jeep. I think we're gonna wind it out here. Again, like, subscribe, and share. Hit that notification bell down below. You get email notifications when my new videos come out. Check out our merch store. Thanks again. Bye for myself, Toki, and my perpetually beautiful wife who's with us in spirit. See ya. Thought I'd show you what driving's like. Pretty impassable if you don't have a four-wheel drive like I drive. See, we got a lot of snow last night, yesterday, and the day before, and a bunch more coming. Toki's in the back there from our hike, laying down. He's probably tired. Kurgan at the end of our hike. I had somebody in comments the other day ask me, what do I wear to stay warm on these hikes? I figured I'd make a quick video to show you that. The base layer I wear, long underwear, bottoms and top are made of wool. I also like to wear a wool hat and wool fingerless gloves. One of the reasons why I prefer wool over cotton is even when wool gets wet, soaking wet, it still retains like 80% of your heat. When cotton gets wet, it wicks the heat away from your body. And so when I'm on a hike like this, if I'm wet from perspiration or from falling in water or snow soaking through my clothes and that, I still stay nice and toasty because of the wool. Again, these gloves here are soaking wet right now and my hands are very warm. Again, wool is awesome for that. I also wear some North Face Sumeru boots. I've had these that I'm wearing right now for four seasons, and they hold up great. I think they probably will have a couple more seasons left in them. I keep ice chains on the boots. They're a godsend when it comes to keeping you on your feet. Again, wool and ice chains. I highly recommend them if you're out in this weather. Bye from myself, my homie Mr. Kurgan. Hope you enjoyed the hike. If you watched the hike we were just on, it's stunningly beautiful. See ya. Say bye, Kurgan. Bye.
Thanks for watching. Check out our merch store down below.